glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. You might think the games get more important as we get deeper into the season. Try selling that to this sellout crowd who's been screaming their guts out and ready for kickoff in the SEC. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Stadium in beautiful Tallahassee, Florida, and we're looking forward to a great game coming up. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Florida State is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He's to the 20. He's got the corner. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. LSU's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Setting up blockers, your running back's got it on the screen. He's tackled around the 41-yard line. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
Good job by the defense to force a punt on the first series.
Well, they had their opportunities here to make some plays to try to quiet this crowd, but they weren't able to do it. If things keep going this way, this stadium is going to get even louder.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And he's tackled right around the 40. Maybe a yard on the option play of the fullback.
That brings up second and nine.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Lateral's back, and he's got space. Gets out to around the 38.
There's nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
From the 38-yard line, first down. He makes his way to about the 28.
Boy, how would you like to be a defensive back and see this guy rumbling at you with a full head of steam? Nicely done by the big man.
Right,
to get nice yardage on that run.
That's a deep five on the play. That brings him second and five.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down. Run up the middle.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Brought down at the eight.
That's a deep line. That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Receiver, touchdown.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
Splits the uprights with the extra point.
Well, these guys lost a lot of talent to graduation last year. They've got to put some new faces in there. And this guy looks like he's the real thing, and he can help in that area.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Gathered in at the six. He's taken down at the 28.
Franklin's the kind of guy that could end up with some national honors because right now he's leading the conference statistically.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Tackle made around the 30-yard line. It's second and eight. Ball on the 30-yard line. Bring him down at about the 29-yard line. Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
Red is waiting for the snap. Tries to get around the corner. Motley fields it at the 37. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Florida State is up by a touchdown.
Here we go. Red and five. Hot, hot, red.
He's at the 40. He's at the 30. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 24.
Wow. For a guy who isn't the fastest player on the field, that was a really impressive run. On the option, no less.
From the 24-yard line. First down. Lateral's back. They'll drop him for a loss.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
Second and 11.
From the 26-yard line. Second down.
Mike is 59. Mike is 59. Set. Red 18. Red 18. Hot.
Tackle around the 28-yard line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. Florida State's lead is a touchdown. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Gets it. He's in space. He goes out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Florida State is up 7. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. All lined up and ready for the kickoff. From the 5-yard line. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They make the stop at the 43-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 43. He's out of bounds at the 46.
That'll make it 7-7.
Caught with room to work. He's taken down around the 43-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
That makes it second and 10.
At about the 35.
That'll bring up third and 2.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. And he's taken down around the 33-yard line.
First down.
And tackled in the backfield.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. And he hits him hard to the 37-yard line. It's the 9th play of the drive. And he might want it all here, and does! No, incomplete. The punter is going to try to pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here. Didn't get all of that one.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
And he's stopped behind the line.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
The Seminoles taking their first time out of the half. 2 minutes left in the half. And they hit him in the backfield.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Pickup.
I actually liked the call, but it was really smart, disciplined play by the defense.
The Tigers are going to call their second timeout.
Bell, the return man. Bell takes it to the 47.
He's tackled at the 41.
The Tigers know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Complete. He's got room. He's tackled at about the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of six on the play.
Hey, first down. Hold it there. Hold it there.
Check, check, check,
check. He's got it with room to run. Good open field tackle.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Now he's scrambling. That's a great tackle at the 10-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he tacks on the extra point.
A nice five-play, 41-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient at throwing the ball.
LSU, kick this one off. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 26-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Florida State is up by three. He's on the run. Diving for extra yardage. Wilkerson picks up about 4 yards after pulling the ball down and scrambling there.
The Seminoles call a timeout. That's their second of the half. From their own 30-yard line.
Second down.
Let's go!
He's scrambling. And he's sacked.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Low scoring first half of play, but a close game. The Seminoles in front, 10-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half.
I'm a fan of seeing guys one-step wrap, two-step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David. But could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense, too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese? Sometimes pretty good defense makes, you know, average offenses look really, really bad. But, you know, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well, and, you know, don't let them throw the fastball, make them throw the curve. And you see great defenses be able to do that all the time, and that's when you can be ultra successful. You have to find ways to make people play, you know, the game out of their comfort zone.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bro. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
He'll return it from the one. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around.
Let's go, defense.
Florida State holds a field goal lead. He's to the 40. And he's tackled at the 44. First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Lateral's back, and he's got space. And he shoved out of bounds around the 42-yard line. To him before he could get back to the line.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
From the 44-yard line, it's second down. And a quick throw, brought down right around the 22-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 22. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Florida State is up a field goal. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
That brings up third and 12.
From the 23-yard line, third down.
Ready?
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, but somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at the 8.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They'll bring him down at the 10.
Nothing doing that time. Defenders stayed home, blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
10th play of the drive. And they got him for a loss.
That makes it 30 goal.
It's third and goal from the 10. They'll probably look to the air here. Florida State has a three-point lead. Defense coming and the ball comes out. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
That would have been a huge momentum swing if the defense had recovered that. This should be an easy field goal. He gets it up, and it is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Beffner gets set to kick this one away. Bell from the 6. What a collision. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. Where in the world was he going on that run?
Well, that's a good question. I thought for a while he got his directions messed up.
From their own 20-yard line. Second down. Makes the catch and look out. Tackle around the 29-yard line. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Throws complete, he's got room to work. And he is drilled at the 35. First down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Scrambling around. Dives for extra yardage. He scrambles there for about 8 yards. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Makes it out to about the 46. That's 3 down and 1 to go. Florida State's lead is 6. Back to the action. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. Strike and he drops it.
Johnson's intended receiver. That makes it second and 10.
From the 46-yard line. Second down. Here comes the pressure. Dives and he's down. Thank you.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. He's hit and taken down.
The offense only got the first down by about a yard, but I'm sure they'll be happy with a new set of downs.
From the 34-yard line, first down. He's taken down at the 26.
That's a deep on one play. That makes it second and two.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. And down he goes around the 14-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 14. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down at the 5.
That brings up second and 1.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. Well, they run it left, and a nice tackle right there. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. 2 for 2 so far on this drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's got it, and we're all tied up. So he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
Here's the extra point that can give them the lead. And he converts the extra point. Crenshaw has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 31-yard line.
The Seminoles have played poorly all day long. That really doesn't matter right now.
They've played sloppy. They're not going to be happy when they go back and look at the film on Monday. But with all that being said, they still have a chance to win this game. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters is trying to get that W.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. He scrambles, runs with it, and he's got room. And he tackles him hard at the 41-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. And they make the stop at the 49-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He pitches it. He's tackled around the 49-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Now he's scrambling. They'll make the sack. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. tries to buy some time.
So a big, big stop on fourth down here late in the fourth quarter. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't?
And he's tackled after positive yardage. McKenzie gets 7 yards on the play. The Seminoles taking their first time out of the half. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He gets to about the 41-yard line.
He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had.
Florida State will use their final timeout.
So it's second and 12.
Ball on the 43-yard line. LSU is up one.
Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee.
He'll get it again. He's at the 30, makes it to the 21.
Well, neither team could muster much of an offense today. It's final. 14-13, Tigers. The Seminoles. That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports from Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.